Hi people, I am Ayushi Srivastav and I am here today at Analytical Minds to have a detailed discussion on the life at College of Medicine and Sagar Datta Hospital. I'm super excited to share my experience with you people, so let's start the video at once. Yeah, so first day of college, definitely it was nerve-wracking. I mean, I remember being super scared and super nervous. Of course, I had a little bit of excitement because it's a completely new journey. It's a new place and a new leap in my life. So yeah, and I remember that day, August, it was raining cats and dogs in Calcutta, and the college is a little far from my house, so you know, the start of the day wasn't very pleasant because, let's be real, if it rains in Calcutta for even 5 minutes, it just gets flooded everywhere. So yeah, I mean, the start was pretty gloomy. I was a little bit annoyed with all the rains and the traveling and everything. But yeah, we entered the college and we were sent into this lecture hall. We had this huge orientation program. We met our principal, our dean, and basically what happened was, like, our anatomy HOD, she set the baseline. I mean, she was the one who actually introduced us to what happens in a medical college, because we all, you know, we were in school all this time. So she was the one who was like, "Acha, aise hota hai, you know, you'll have this many semesters, fir prof exams honge, and then items hoga, parts hoga." So she was the one who set it for us, like set the stage for us. And we went to the anatomy museum, and the reaction to the anatomy museum was very amusing because we could see all these dead fetuses around and we were like, okay, what's happening? That's when I realized, okay, I am here, I am in a medical college now. So yeah, and also, yes, we have 3 canteens in our college, so I think the main attraction for me on the very first day was the canteen. Yeah, so that was how my first day. Yeah, so first of all, I would just say that our college is comparatively new to the other colleges that are there in Calcutta. So definitely from that point of view, if I want to say, we definitely have a better infrastructure, although we don't have any crumbling buildings, God forbid. So that way it's pretty nice. And of course, we have a new cancer institute built in our college, which I don't think so other medical colleges in Calcutta have. So yeah, that's the major thing in our college. And I mean, I'm in third year right now, and when I had joined college, I was in first year 3 years back. I have literally seen my college grow and become better, so there's definitely so much potential in this college. So I would consider to be very lucky to be here. Okay, so the course curriculum in MBBS is actually same in all colleges. There's not a lot of difference. There's actually no difference. I'm just going to discuss about, like, the syllabus and what all is done. In first year, now it's been changed. In first year, you all will have 3 semesters and 3 subjects, which is anatomy, biochemistry, and physiology. Just brace yourself for anatomy, because anatomy is tough. I'm not going to sugarcoat it. But I mean, we all went through it, so you all will get through it too. In second year, you all will have 2 semesters, and the subjects would be pathology, pharmacology, and microbiology. In third year, also you all will have 2 semesters, and the subjects will be now 4. It's been newly changed. So it will be forensic medicine, toxicology. You all will have community medicine, ENT, and ophthalmology. In final year, we actually have 9 subjects. It's a lot, of course, which will include your medicine, surgery, gyneobs, pedia, ortho, radiology, derma, anesthesia, and psychiatry. I'm really scared to be going to final year, but yeah, so that's the course curriculum, and same in all the colleges. And our colleges, they usually try their best to keep the semesters for every year at least 1 month before your university exams, so that we get ample time to prepare for the exam. Okay, so I think I'm gonna speak very highly of the teaching faculty in our college. I mean, I really feel all the professors and all the years are really, really good. I mean, apart from their own academic excellence, they are very helpful, and they actually reach out to the students and they make sure that every student understands every lecture. And they put in a lot of effort, from presentations to practical classes to tutorial classes to all these different kind of ways that they help us to understand every lecture and every topic. I mean, they are really there to guide you, and not just teaching and learning, but also like everything about exams. I mean, how to prepare for exams, what to study for exams, how to study for the exams, and how to study these topics. And you know how the teachers or the externals are gonna ask questions and everything. So it's a whole circle. So they are really helpful that way. I mean, of course, there are some teachers that are always gonna be a little strict, but like they will be strict when they're teaching you. But in the end, during exams, they're really, really helpful, and they really try their best to make the child feel comfortable also during classes, which is actually a very big plus point. So yeah. Okay, so the campus of a college is actually good. I mean, considering the location of my college, I wasn't expecting a lot, but the campus is quite huge. And let me tell you, we have 3 ponds in our campus, and it's very serene and beautiful. And I've spent evenings in our college, and the sunsets are so beautiful. I mean, it's perfect for all our aesthetic pictures that we take. So yeah, the academic building and the hostel building, these two are separate buildings. We have 3 hostels for girls, boys, and there's an interns hostel as well. Like I said earlier, we have 3 canteens, and yeah, it's big. I mean, we have a very big audi, it's quite big, and we have a library as well for all the students to study. That way, of course, I'm not gonna say it's a government hospital, it's not gonna be like perfect and like all so nice and everything, but you know, like compared to where we are and what we're studying and everything, the campus is quite sufficient. Seniors, okay, yeah, seniors, I think I've gotten the best seniors, I think. I mean, there's always been this prejudice in colleges that, you know, you need to wish good morning sir or good morning ma'am to your seniors, or you can't look them in the eye or talk to them, you can't argue with them. But I didn't have any experience like that in our college. The seniors are very, very helpful. And I mean, I remember last year we were giving freshers, we were organizing freshers for our juniors. And like our seniors, they without even asking for help, they were there for us to, and they actually helped us with the decorations and like the organizing the fest. I was so grateful that they are there, because they really help us and they stand with us. And regarding studies also, I mean, seniors actually help us a lot with exams, you know, what to study, how to study, from like giving notes to giving like underlining all the topics and the, you know, chapters which are important to study, like those last minute tips and tricks that they give. So that way the seniors are very helpful, and you'll never feel like any, like I've actually personally never felt any sense of uncomfort with them. And I mean, I've seen my seniors, and I'm a senior too, and we actually try our best to be friends with our juniors so that they don't feel uncomfortable, because they're gonna spend like, I mean, 5.5 years here, so we need to like be a whole big family. So yeah, patient load is, I think I'm gonna say it's quite sufficient. That's the word I'm gonna use. I'll be very honest, the patient load is not quite high, you know, that we see in other like government colleges and everything. It's not very high, but at the same time it's not very less also. So it's a sufficient amount, and it's enough for us to study and learn all the clinics. Okay, hostel life. So my house is a little far from my college, so I stay in the hostel and come home during the weekends. Hostel, first of all, it's actually very clean and hygienic because our college is new, so it's all clean, tidy, new buildings have been made. Like every room is quite spacious, two people share one room, and we have common washrooms, and the cleaning lady, she cleans those washrooms as well as the hostel corridors every day, and you can also ask her to specifically clean your individual rooms. We have a lift, and we have the canteen downstairs. So all of that, it's quite okay. I mean, I'm not gonna say it's like it's furnished, it's very nice and everything, but it's manageable. I mean, they give you a table, chair, a bed too. So that way, I feel the hostel is pretty nice. Okay, the very famous hostel mess food. Of course, I'm being very honest here. The canteen food is actually not very good. I wouldn't say that. But then again, it's not very bad also, okay? You get biryani and you get good food also sometimes. It's not like that. So, I mean, it's tolerable. Like, if you're staying in the hostel, you have to, you know, adjust and manage a little. So from that point of view, I'll say that hostel food is tolerable. That's the word, tolerable. Okay, so my advice, I think I would recommend College of Medicine and Sadarjata Hospital to all my juniors. I mean, it's a great college. You will have definitely have a great experience here, like both the social experience as well as the learning experience in this college. The environment is great, the teachers are good, your seniors, and I mean, they're very helpful, always available for you. And of course, the main highlight can also be that it's in the city, so you can enjoy the city life too, being in the college. And yeah, so it's a great, I've had a great experience, and I'm sure y'all will have a great experience too if you join the college. It's I can see my college getting better day by day, so it's a great experience, obviously.